is Mr. New Vegas, and I feel something magic in the air tonight, and I'm not just talking about the gamma radiation. Here are our top stories. A big congratulations to a young band of soldiers who shattered NCR records on a combat readiness evaluation at Camp Golf. Go get 'em, guys. Also in the headlines, NCR Correctional Facility is now under prisoner control following a successful riot. Locals should avoid anyone who looks like they've done time. Those are our stories for this hour. This is Mr. New Vegas signing off. Just kidding. I'm not going anywhere. My love for you is too strong.
You know, it's kind of funny. I really need to go and visit that NCR correctional facility. Those inmates have been having to run of that place for far too long. But anyways, welcome back to more Fallout New Vegas. I'm TBG Hunter, and last time we did nothing really story-wise. We just went around and explored the Mojave. Got a couple power armors from our exploration, got some star bottle caps, and also got a little bit more of the map filled out. Today we're going to be heading back to New Vegas, but you might be wondering, well, New Vegas is all the way over there. What the hell are you doing so far from New Vegas? Well, since we're going to be doing some work for the Strip, I thought I might as well get the talent pool quest out of the way, and it requires us to be in this sort of general area, the Strip itself, and Freeside again. Yes, I'm sorry about going back to Freeside. So I thought, you know what, we're going to be back on the Strip, and we're going to be spending some time there. Might as well knock this out of the park while we are at it. So, first things first, we could have gone to Novak, but I feel like this would have been a better start to our little escapade because, A, we get a unique weapon out of this if I play my cards right, and, you know, me, I probably won't be getting this weapon because I never play my cards right, but also because there's a little bit of backstory to this character that we're going to advocate as a talent agent, or, well, offer a job as a talent agent. Offer him the job because we are the talent agent. Damn, I cannot talk. Anyways, let us talk to this fella. I don't remember if we actually did talk to him.
Howdy there, partner.
We have talked to him already. It must have been our first time passing through the area to New Vegas. Tommy Taroni at the Topps Casino is looking for musical acts, if you're interested.
Maybe it's time to give these tired old bones a rest. All right, show me what you've got.
I'm giving you a real opportunity here. How's about it, some compensation?
I suppose it's only right you get a little something for your troubles. Here, my daddy left me this gun. Guess I don't need it no more.
We got ourselves the mysterious Magnum, and apparently he just walked through fire, no problem whatsoever. We also gave him our business card, now we just need to find three entertainers. Now, the mysterious Magnum is... It's a really gimmicky weapon. Also, as you can see, I decided to deposit most of my weapons back at the 38 because since we're going to be doing work for the casinos on the Strip, most of my weapons are going to be completely useless. So instead, we're going to go with the Mysterious Magnum. We're going to take a look because, A, it has one of the best drawn put away animation or, well, sounds in the entire game. Just listen. Yeah, it's the Mysterious Stranger theme, and is that another Legion party? No, that's just dance. And you know what? Why don't we test out our new and trusty shiny Magnum on these ants over here? Just need to... Wow, this thing hits pretty hard. I also decided to give Arcade the Smithy Special, because he's a big, like, advocate for energy weapons, and... Given his background of him carrying a plasma defender, it's only right to give him a plasma-based energy weapon. Wow, I did not discover the dry lake already? Huh, weird. While we're on the topic of unique Mojave weapons, I went to Mick and Ralph's, sold most of the weapons and other assortments we got there, and picked myself up a nice little bludgeoning instrument known as the Nuka Breaker. So we're gonna go over... It's actually a really good weapon to use against robot enemies, so if I ever decide to go to an area that's, like, covered crawling with robots instead of crawling with bugs, it's is gonna be one of the best, like, weapons to have for the job. And, you know, I thought I, you know, should have stayed a little bit of love because it is based off one of the best Fallout machinimas out there, or, well, fan stories, fan movies, whatever. So, whoa, that was really bad lag on my part. Enough playing around with the ants, let us head over to Novak, because that is where our second talent is. And then after that, we're going to be heading to the Atomic Wrangler, and I don't remember where the last talent agent is. Or the last talent character I need to scout. No, that's just a caravan. For a second, I forgot that caravans actually do have, like, the guards always carrying the weapons out in full view of everyone. Okay, now which door was it? This door? Probably, I guess so, because I don't think there's a door above me. Maybe. Hello? There's a mushroom growing in the bathtub, but yeah, I'm just gonna back out of here. Anything in the cabinet? Eh. Oh, arcade. Wait, is there anyone in here? Nope, just me and Arcade and Eddie. Nice. Then I guess I'll just steal these pre-war books. Yeah, evil karma. Evil karma can bite me. I guess our talent scout we need to go see is on the second floor. And right here.
We can't
there he is.
While the Legion prepares their own elite forces.
What elite forces? You mean those assassins they keep sending me that I keep murdering? Also, how did you get a motorcycle in here?
Oh, please don't kill me. I swear I'll have... Wait. You don't work for Mr. Bishop, do you?
No, I don't. What makes you think that?
Sorry, it's just... You look like his type, you know? You got that hard-ass wasteland explorer thing going on.
I took a bunch of drugs before coming here, so that might give you the impression that I look like I'm a bit of a troublemaker. Aren't you that singer from New Reno? I think I saw you play at the clubs there.
Oh, so you have heard of me. Yeah, that's right. I was the big draw at the Shark Club. People used to pay hundreds of caps to see me.
If you're looking for work... Wait, why'd you come all the way here from New Reno?
You don't know Mr. Bishop. He's not like other bosses up there. He knows the wasteland like the back of his hand, and he likes to wander it. I knew if I didn't get way the hell away from New Reno, he'd run me down like a dog.
Why would Bishop be after you?
Oh, well, that's all just a big misunderstanding, see? Mr. Bishop? Well, he owed me a lot of money, and, you know, he's a busy guy, so I sort of figured I'd just take it off his hands.
You robbed a casino boss.
Robbed is such an ugly word. It's more like I took care of a payroll problem for him. Also, I might have sort of plowed his daughter. A little.
Well, hats off to you. That takes some balls.
Thanks. But if Bishop finds me and I don't have his money, my balls are going to be on his trophy wall.
Well, if you're looking for work, Tommy is hiring singers at the Tops.
Really? The Tops, huh? Well, it's no Shark Club, but I hear security on the Strip is real tight. Even Mr. Bishop wouldn't hit a joint like that. I'll check it out. Thanks.
All right. That's good to go. I'll see you there, buddy. We got plenty of chems, we got plenty of booze, and we got plenty of acts for you to take part in. Now, damn it, Cliff buddy here, or no, Bruce. I don't know why I was saying Cliff. I guess because I was thinking of the shop owner. His whole story is just basically one big callback to Fallout 2, because the Shark Club, Mr. Bishop, and all that stuff were like characters, and New Reno itself was a location in Fallout 2. And it kind of plays into the fact that it's... I don't remember, I think it's... the same Bishop from Fallout 2. I think it's more along the fact of the Chosen One, because you do go through New Reno and deal with the bishops there, and may or may not have slept with his wife and decided to give him a kid if it was the male character. So it probably would be that the child of the Chosen One decided to take over the family and arguably is a terrible person, and also thank you for taking them out. Arcade, you look absolutely hilarious when you're just carrying that thing around. Alright. Finally, at the Atomic Wrangler. Thankfully, we do not have to spend a whole lot of time here in the Freeside, so that's a plus. The minus, on the other hand, is we're still back in Freeside. And it's become a running gag of how many times I've just visited this place. And something tells me it's not going to be the last time. Hardeen?
Whoa, baby. Am I looking at a mirror? Or are you just that ugly?
Watch your mouth, ghoul. I might just rip your jaw off.
Whoa, Nelly. There's insult comedy, and then there's psycho comedy. I guess you aren't the heckler Garrett hired to spice up my show. What do you want?
You perform stand-up comedy, huh?
Yeesh, is my act that bad? Or are you just that dumb? Yeah, that's right. Got me a nice juicy contract with the management.
Judging by the economics today of Freeside, they can't be paying that much.
Okay, I admit it. I ain't exactly rowing in caps here. But what do you want? I'm under contract. I can't get out.
Well, Tommy is hiring new acts at the Tops. I think you can make good money there.
Too bad I got this ironclad contract with the Garretts. They'll never let me out of it.
I could talk to the Garretts. I've done enough favors for them for a long time.
Garrett's a tough, mean son of a bitch. He's not likely to give up. Let me know if you make any headway.
Well, they kind of owe me one, and also I'm a silver ton devil, so there's that.
I hear the Legion is camping out across the river. I hope they're not planning to attack. Those bloodthirsty mole rats are never up to any good.
Yeah, well, our boys in brown will be able to take care of anything that they send our way. I'd like to get Hardeen out of his contract.
Now, why would I want to do that? His performances make me quite a lot of money.
He's not the right fit for this place. You'll find better performers, or I could go with the barter of how much do you lose to folks not coming to a place with a ghoul performer. But that's kind of mean, even for me. Even though I told him I'd rip his jaw off his face when he insulted me like that. You know what? Let's just go with the speech.
I suppose you've got a point. Plenty of Brahmin on the prairie and all that. Fine, I'll cut him loose. He's all yours.
Thank you. I also spoke to Julie. She said the followers will accept your offer.
Hey, that's great. We'll get some supplies sent over today as a show of good faith. Once our stills are upgraded, we'll never be short on liquor for our patrons. If Jacob Hoff is sober, we might even have a few new drinks on tap. Most might view us as drug-dealing enablers around here. But honestly, we care about our patrons. It's bad business for people to get addicted. We've got enough crime in Freeside without a bunch of strung-out junkies robbing traders and gamblers to afford their next fix.
Eh, we got some fame from Freeside. Did we get some followers fame? No, apparently not. And also, I could have sworn I already told them that the followers were willing to accept their offer. Weird, I know. But whatever. Hardeen?
Garrett yet?
Hardeen is... Garrett's asked me to let you out of your contract. You can now go work at the Tops.
Really? You mean I'm finally out of this shithole? That's great. Thank you.
And that's Talon Act number 3. Now we just need to find one more. There's one more entertainer for the Tops. Yeah. The quest log doesn't really like to update itself in the right order, as I've come to find. And also I like how he says that there's junkies that come out of the woodworks to get a fix, even though I've been literally killing every single one that I've seen, and mostly that was Eddie who's doing most of the killing. But you get my point, they die in like one or two hits. And I guess desperate people take desperate measures. Thankfully, I got my lucky magnum with me. Anything that tries to come in my way gets hot lead to the head. Oh, okay, that's meh. Let's just get back to the strip and see where we have to go next. Honestly, I don't remember where this last act is. I think he might be in the vault. Possibly? Let's take a look at... Alright, well, there's the Tops. That's a bit further. So I think that is the vault that we need to go to. Now, Gamora is going to be our next stop on the trek through the strip. because we still got to do the main quest that's with Gamora. And there's a very particular way I need to do that quest, because if you remember when we went to Mick and Ralph's way back in, I don't even remember when we first went there. Wait, what? Wait, the thing is at Gamora? Or is it over here? Oh, wait. No, it's this guy. Okay.
It's true. Hey, come on, pal. I'm trying to put on a show here. You're welcome.
Dude, nice hairstyle.
All right, then make it snappy, kid. This isn't exactly a lucrative career enterprise here.
Who are you?
The name's Knight. Billy Knight. And this here's what a lifelong career in comedy will get you. Oi.
Oi. Stand on a street corner in the middle of nowhere?
That's exactly my point, kid. Exactly my point!
God, it's like an older version of me. Tommy Taroni at the Tops is hiring entertainers. I could put in a word for you.
Yeah? Hey, you're all right. Tell him I'll do it for 100 a night. No, 50. No, 20. 10. Just don't rob me. I'll do it.
Don't sell yourself short. You're worth a lot more than that.
Jeez, what was I thinking? You're right. I gotta go in there with a cool head. Tell them how much I'm really worth.
Oh, look at him go. Man, he's hauling ass. Well, with all that said and done, we are finally able to go and finish the last quest for the Tops. I'm kind of weird that there's only like two things that you can do for the Tops. I guess quest-wise, there's more because there is like quests guaranteed towards, you know, getting X amount of caps at the casinos. Also, I probably should put my gun away. There's also, you know, getting kicked out. Getting kicked out of the casinos. But I'm never going to do that because my luck isn't really that high enough to, you know, be able to pull that off. Alright, so where is Tommy Boy? Oh, there you are.
Hey, hey, welcome, welcome, welcome to the finest entertainment experience in New Vegas. My name is Tommy Taroni, and how can I make your night?
I've been saying Taroni, potato, potato. Let's talk about the acts I recruited.
Cowboy act? Yeah. He dropped on in here not too long before you. He's got chops, baby, real chops. And I ain't just talking about that mustache. And like we agreed, here's your fee. 5% of the cut comes to 166 caps. Don't spend them all in one place now, unless it's right here.
All right, next act.
You talking about Mr. Isaac? Damn, baby, when you bring them in, you bring them in. That cat's gonna bring me money like you wouldn't believe. Here's your 5%, baby. You enjoy that. That comedian, you mean? Yeah. He was a hell of a haggler. Cost me a pretty cap. Hope he's worth it. Here's your 5%.
And last
that
act.
That ugly mug with the razor tongue? Take it, baby. He'll be one hell of a novelty act, just like Tommy promised. Here's your 5%.
You That's know great. It, baby. Take and with all that done, talent pool is finished. And I'm liked on the strip. Nice. Now, the fun thing about finishing this quest, the acts that you actually hired do follow a set schedule, and you can actually just watch them right here in the theater. I'll probably throw it up on screen right now of the time each act goes up, so you can, like, get a little base of when in time you want to come in and watch the acts, which they're kind of enjoyable to watch. I've come here a couple times just to see how my work has paid off. But with our work at the Tops done, it is time to head off to the stingy abyss that is Gamora. And sorry, this is nothing like the Guardians of the Galaxy Gamora. It is more of the sleazy side of Vegas. Even more than Freeside is. But it's nice to see this whole brightness that's filled the air. It kind of takes part in what I've been doing staying out in the wasteland for so long. Never being able to take in, like, the sights, the sounds, and the entertainment. But we probably won't be enjoying ourselves for long. Oops. Actually, before I go in any deeper, I forgot I need to go to the NCR embassy to get that lead on what we need to do for the NCR here.
Hey, no one but Omertas are allowed to carry guns into Gamora. Check your weapons with me.
Yes, sir.
You'll get these back on your way out.
I'll get these back right now because I have to head back to the embassy. Alright, sorry about that little detour. I just wanted to, you know, cut out the middleman so we can find this receptionist to talk to. Which is right over here. I mean right over here. Sorry about that.
I heard you killed Benny over at the Tops. I bet you think you're some sort of tough cookie.
Well, I don't think. Advice. I know.
If you mess with any of my men, you'll regret it.
Hey, I got no beef with the NCR. I'm the one who's keeping this army afloat.
Welcome back. What can I do for you this time?
Moore sent me to talk about the Omertas.
Ah, excellent. I received word you may be coming. We helped the receptionist over at Gamora with some thugs that were taking advantage of her. She owes us a favor. Go talk to her. She'll be able to point you in the right direction.
All right, will do.
Sir?
Finally, some recognition for my status in the NCR. It's nice to be called Sir every now and then. It makes me smile on the inside, even though I have a murder face on the outside. All right, we are back in Gamora. Yes, 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 I know. Can't carry my weapons inside the casino. Here's my stuff, even though I have my holdout weapons. Let's finally begin this trek.
Hello, and welcome to Gamora. What can I help you with today?
I'm calling in for an outstanding balance of some information. Tell me what the Omertas are up to.
I knew someone would call in that mark soon. What do you want to know?
I didn't know what's been going on with Gamora.
All I can tell you is to find Kachino. He's the lowest level lieutenant you're going to be able to talk to. Some of the girls say he's been involved in some shady business the family wouldn't really like. Ask him about it.
All right. Anything else going on around here?
Feel free to head to our club, Brimstone, or you can see our gorgeous courtyard out behind the casino.
All right, then. I'm sure you have some good dirt on what's going on around here.
I sure do, but loose lips sink ships.
Don't worry about me. I can keep secrets.
All right. You look pretty trustworthy.
Oh, I guess that was just the other way you could get it if you didn't go to the NCR embassy. Alright, let's go. And Arcade, be sure to be wearing golf shoes. Otherwise, we won't get out of here alive. Incredibly bright in here. No, it's not my Pip-Boy that's making it so bright. What the hell? It says there's an enemy in here. Weird.
I hear you've been asking questions about me, dickweed. What the fuck do you want?
Wow, this door is very forthcoming. I hear you've been doing some businesses on the side.
Business? What the fuck do you mean, business? You looking to get yourself burned? Now you start talking real clear, and I mean fucking crystal clear, because I'm about to lose my patience.
Man, this door has a potty mouth on it. I hear you've been dealing with some businesses that is off limits for the family.
I don't give half a dick what you heard. Now get the fuck out of my face before I burn your sorry ass.
Very rude, Mr. Door. I ought to beat the ever-living hell out of you. I'm gonna beat the devil out of you. I must be on acid right now. The doors are starting to insult me. Well, there's nothing we can really do right now, seeing as how Kachinko has a chip on his shoulder the size of the casino. So why don't we instead, no, not go to the lower lobby. Arcade, why do you look like you're sneaking around? Not to the courtyard. Where is the way to the upper floors? I think it was the elevators back out here? Possibly? Yeah, here we go. We need to go to the upper floors, suites. Behind us, we need to go find Kachinko's room to steal a little bit of information on him so we can, you know, have some dirt on him. I don't think it's this room. I think this is just the hotel room we get. Let's see. No. Anything back here? Uh-oh. Oh. Well, this is the kitchen. Maybe it was just a very, like, bloody mess of a kitchen. To the restrooms? Okay, maybe not. Smashed mirrors, blood all over the place. Nothing in here. What kind of holdout weapons do I have on me right now, just to be sure? I've got my Silenced 22 pistol and Love and Hate. And a camera. Oh boy. I guess I don't have the stealth required to sneak Sleepy Time into the casinos just yet, because I think I need at least 50 stealth to do so. Which then completely negates my reasons for getting Sleepy Time in the first place, but eh, what can you do? Let's see, what's in here? That's a door that's very hard, that's a guard that's not going to go anywhere, and that's a door that's very hard as well. Anything over here? Is there another guard? Yes, there is. I could, you know, sneak this way. Come on. They never saw it coming. Anything in here worth stealing? A knife? Ooh. A controller that's about ready to die again. Doesn't look like there's anything worthwhile in here to take. I guess conductors that are worth a little bit of money, but other than that, nothing.
I tell you, not at home is gonna have his day.
Yeah, whatever you say. Hey, buddy.
Business is good. All the family's got money. Of course, Gamora is where the action is.
You stare firmly at that wall. I'm just gonna, you know, just be a locksmith. I heard this door has been having trouble opening up, so I've come to take a look at it.
I'm gonna clip your sorry ass.
I hope nobody heard that. Shit, we need to hide the body now. Come on, just sneak it in here. There we go. Take his brain matter as well. Come on. Off the floor. Man, this guy has got a very heavy head. Come on. Get in there. Come on. Come on. There we go. All right. Now it's like we weren't even here. There's bloodstains all over the place, so I'm sure they won't mind. All right, let's get in here and see what we have to dig up on Kachinko. The Kachinko machine. Nothing. Nothing at all. Maybe there's something on the upper floors. Footlocker. Some money. Nice. There's some books over here we can take. There's a salesman weekly. I could use that. And also a locksmith reader. And some mentats. And some money. I'm becoming an evil bastard by doing this, but nothing the little fiend hunting expedition won't fix. Something tells me this isn't the right... This is one of the boss's rooms right here. Let's get the hell out of here. Okay, so this isn't the right room. And also, hey, a sawed-off shotgun. Nice. Apparently, I managed to get away with murder. I wonder if that guy... Is he coming back this way? He'll hear it. I don't know if he heard the last one. Right, maybe I can get you to look this way.
Holy shit, you've been in Lucky 38? You meet the big man in there?
Yes, I did meet the big man. And guess what, buddy? You're about to meet the big man himself as well. Stranger, I think you got him. Also, I think that guard just heard that. just gonna open up this door. We're just gonna sneak in here and hope the guard doesn't come looking for his buddy. Could have sworn it was in one of these rooms up here that we need to find his spare journal, or at least dig up some dirt on Kachinko. If not, then I can just always do it the other way, of course, unless the entire casino is out for my head. It doesn't look like I'm finding anything in here as well. Damn it. Alright, I guess it's time to do it the other way. Better dispose of the body first, though. Thank God I've upgraded lockpicking. There is a... Just put you in here. We'll let the lady have a little bit of company. Come on, get your leg in here. Get over there. Oof. Where's a doctor's bag in here? Well, is someone doing some, like, shoddy surgery? There's a bone saw as well. This is some, like, seven shit going on. Let's just close this and forget we saw anything. Alright. Did the guard... I don't think he's... No, he's not red, so maybe we got away with it? Eddie, I see you got a teleporting feature, which also means that wasn't the guard that was there, that was just Eddie. Hello, sir?
What the fuck is that thing?
What? Are you talking about this getup, this partner, or this robot? It's over here. That's hard. Go the other way. What's in this room real quick? I just want to make sure. I think I might have already checked out this place. Yeah, I already checked out this place. This was the room with, like, the bloody bathroom and the bloody, kitchen area. Where do these lead?
I got kicked out of Ultralux the other day. Man, that place gives me the fucking freaks.
Really, does it now? Alright, well, I can't really take that elevator unless I want to get every guard on my ass. Yes, that is a robot, sir. Very astute. Alright, come on, go around the corner. Go around the corner. And he's out of here. Alright, last door. If this is not behind door number 3, then... Well, technically, I guess door number 4. Then I guess I'm going to be doing some pickpocketing. Which, I don't have the best track record when it comes to the Fallout games. Or the Elder Scrolls games. Get in the door! Hello? Anyone home? Muscle preview, dressers... Not seeing anything in terms of what would look like a piece of evidence to use against Pachinko, buddy. Guess I have to do it the hard way. Alright. I guess back to... Brimstone. Oh, wait, was it... No, it was the main level. Damn it! Or was it? Nope, it was the main level. Odd placement that they put you. It would just be weird that they had the elevators way off to the side and not, like, at the middle. Alright. Well, let's head back to that showman area. Where did... Okay, there he is, sitting right there. This is not going to be easy. You know what? This calls for something that can up my sneak a little bit. So we're going to read a comic book. I'm also going to save right here. Why? Because I really don't trust myself when it comes to the shenanigans. All right. Got to take his journal. Everything rides on me being able to have daft hands. Nice. Let's have a look at this journal and see what businesses Kachinko Buddy's been up to. Documents a couple months of Kachinko's activity as it contains a detailed leisure of describing many of his business deals over the last few months, including the sales of Kem's weapons. It's clear that a quick glance that these transactions are of his own personal finances, and this is done behind the backs of the Umerta family management structure. He also talks in great detail about many sexual encounters with Gamora prostitutes, including Joanna. After nearly every off-the-book sale or sexual tryst, he vows that this one will be his last.
I'm glad they don't let just any motherfucker through the gate. Freeside smells like shit. You again? What the fuck do you want?
Well, you say Freeside smells like shit. Well, I smell bullshit on you. I found this ledger that proves some of your side businesses.
Where the fuck did you get that? Okay, listen, buddy. That's some dangerous shit you got there. That book can get me killed if the wrong people see it. Let's talk. What do you want? What can I do for you?
I'll consider giving it to you for some cash up front.
Okay, you got me by the balls. Here's a couple hundred caps. Maybe that'll buy you friendship.
This journal's also worth at least 100 more to you.
I can pay you for it, of course. I also have some information about the family's business that you might find interesting. Between you and I, we can break up what they're planning, maybe save some lives. Mine included, of course.
Alright, 100 caps, and help me break up whatever the bosses are planning.
Oh, here's some caps. Now give me the journal. Alright, there we go. So let me tell you what I know about the family's business. The bosses, Big Sal and Nero, have been working for a while on this. They're arming themselves like an army, using this new guy, Troike. They also brought in a specialist named Clandon. At least that's what they introduced him as.
What kind of specialist is Carlton?
I got no fucking idea. They let him have the run of the place, though. He seems like a nice guy, but he makes me nervous. He's a little arrogant, but he's too nice. Too open. I've never seen him fucking or gambling. Everyone has a vice, but this guy seems like the Pope.
The Wasteland Pope, huh? Well, I'm slowly becoming the Wasteland Messiah myself. Alright, more questions.
Okay, toss them at me.
Tell me about this Troike character.
He's a skittish little fucker. Spends half the day pumping his body full of chems and the other half pumping hookers with his willy. He has some kind of connections, so he's able to smuggle huge shipments of weapons into the strip. The bosses got him by the short hairs. We covered up a hooker he killed while flying on some psycho, so he gets his guns in exchange for not ratting.
Interesting. Do you know anything about what they're planning?
No, just that it involves guns and muscle. Also that it's big. Very big. Only Nero and Big Saul know everything, and they ain't telling.
Alright, and that's pretty much everything I have.
You can find me here or upstairs in my room. I'll let the muscle know you're a friend of mine. That should let you get around a little easier.
Ew. Well, this is awkward. Alright, so let's head off to Brimstone then. Hopefully the guards still haven't found those two dead bodies that I left. Actually, do I actually do want to be here? Maybe I should go back up and check out that body. I'm a little bit lost now because I really haven't been to Brimstone in a while.
I tell you, not at home is going to have his day.
That's a very hard door. That is another area. Did I already just come across where Troike is? Apparently I did.
Who are you? I didn't do anything. Leave me alone.
Alright, so do I want to talk to him about the guns or the prostitute? The prostitute.
Oh, man. I don't even like to think about it. All that goddamn blood. It was just in the hotel like any other night. I took some Kims with the girl I was with, but I never black out. I did this time, though. Next thing I knew, I woke up, she was lying next to me, stabbed dead. There was a knife next to the bed, and I was covered in her blood.
Do you know where the knife came from?
I keep a little switchblade tucked away with me. You never know when you might find some trouble.
Interesting to hear. Let's go and investigate the hooker. We're going to be doing some CSI shit here on the strip. CSI New Vegas. CSI Miami, CSI New York. I think there's only two, like, CSI shows that there are.
That follower fucker is going to have some trouble if he tries to liberate any of our employees.
You got some problem with my friend? I already took out two of your buddies. You really want to start some shit with me? Nobody messes with my friends. The body was back this way. Did they already relieve the guards? Nope, they're still dead. Who opened this door? Let's see. This woman is dead. Would you like to inspect to see if we can get any more information? 35 medicine or higher required. Let's inspect the body. The girl appears to have been tortured for several hours and then murdered, judging by the rate of liver mortis. You can only guess the body has been here for less than a day. There's the knife. And you know what? I'll take the sawed-off shotgun as well. Just, you know, have a little bit of extra firepower on me. I do like what they did with the casinos of how you need to approach this like kind of like a Hitman game where you start off with little to no weapons and you need to find a way to sneak in more weapons. Alright, back in Gamora. Let's go talk about Troy. We need to go talk to him about this prostitute again.
Oh, man. I don't even like to... Next.
What kind of chems were you doing?
That night? Mostly buff out. I like to cut it with a little bit of jet and wash it down with some whiskey. That was my standard Saturday night.
Now, that doesn't sound like enough to get you to lose a whole night.
What? Yeah, you're right. I wonder what was up with that.
Alright, next we need the passengers. Alright, how did the family find out about it?
When I saw the body, I started screaming. In a few seconds, some of their soldiers were in there cleaning up the room. They offered to keep silent about what happened if I agreed to help them get their hands on large quantities of guns at deep discounts.
Would you like me to try and get you out of that contract?
You'd do that for me? I'm not sure what can be done, but you'd be doing me a solid if you would. I've been talking to Big Saul mostly.
Alright, well, time to go find one of the bosses. I'm guessing elevator to suites. This is the closest way to the waypoint, so might as well go this way.
There's some serious shit going on between us.
And of course it would be having to go back to the main level. So why didn't it just lead me to an elevator that led to the main level? I guess it would make more sense since this was actually just pretty quick to just go through two elevators and not, you know, trek all the way through the casino to find Big Saul. Now I just need to know where they are. Can I go through the store? Yes, I can. I need to go find the bosses, which... if I know any form of management, it's always overlooking the business. Not this. Not this. Maybe it was out this way. Or maybe I was wrong. Oh, I got... two guys, any of them one of the bosses, just a thug. Oh, there he is.
Hey, you're Cuccino's friend. You got business with me?
Yeah, I got business with ya. I'd like to talk to you about Troik.
Ah, Troik. What you want, some more jet? A fresh batch of girls? Maybe a guy or two this time?
Something about... story doesn't sit right with me.
What, that he's a murdering jethead? Not a new story around here.
Triggs is pretty strung out. He'd be more trouble than he's worth.
Yeah, I see where you're coming from. Okay, tell Troik he can hit the road.
All right, will do.
All right, come back anytime.
You seem very polite for a mob boss. It's gonna be a shame I have to put you in the ground soon. Troik, I have good news for you. Hit the road.
You again. Make it quick.
But you know what? Big Sol agreed to let you go.
Holy shit. Really? Okay, I'll help you. But I'm getting the hell out of here first chance I get.
Alright, let's see what we have to do about the guns.
They're keeping them in a little utility section down off the basement. I don't know what they're arming themselves for, but I know it isn't for the good of mankind.
How do you get guns onto the strip?
I'm pretty proud of myself. It's a stroke of genius if I could be so modest. The whole arrangement starts with an old buddy of mine in the Republic. He's responsible for packing and shipping supplies to the NCR on the strip. He marks some containers as food and medical and packs them with guns and other shit. From there, it took just a couple of greased palms to get someone to let me cherry pick a container or two out of every shipment. Easy as pie.
Interesting. Alright, what can we do about taking care of those guns?
As a little pet project, I've been making some thermite. Thermite burns as hot as the devil's asshole and can melt through just about anything. I've been keeping it so if the family betrays me, I can hopefully do some damage before I end up dead or in jail.
Alright, well, give me that thermite and I'll destroy those weapons. You do not want to actually pass this speech check, believe it or not, so let's just do it ourselves. Actually, first things first, what the hell is thermite?
Thermite is a mix of rust and aluminum dust. If you add a little heat, a massive amount of heat is spit out. It gives off enough heat to melt through just about anything. It should make short work of the weapons.
Interesting. Nice little chemistry lesson.
Here's the thermite and a key to the room where the guns are stored. Place the thermite on the crates in the room. I rigged the light switch outside the room to kick off a spark big enough to hold the thermite. That should turn that shit into molten slag. As soon as we're done talking, I'm gonna make myself like a ghost. I don't want to be anywhere near here when the bosses find out.
Well, good luck with that.
Okay, cool.
And he's... Wow, he bolted fast. Alright, let's do a little bit of science, shall we? Don't mind me, just gonna do a little bit of explosives. Man, he's been a busy boy, hasn't he? Ooh, a nice little footlocker, even though it's really a trunk. Ammo, an assault carbine, a sniper rifle. Man, he's been busy. Two flamethrowers. And that's pretty much it. Alright. But you know what? Something tells me shit is about ready to become real. So let's take this nice little assault carbine as a little bit of insurance. Actually, better yet, I should probably hotkey it so that way I can, you know, take it on and off when I need to. Alright, thermite goes here. Wow, that was a lot of thermite I had in my pockets. Thermite goes here. You know what? Let's dab a little bit over here. And a little bit more here, just for good measure. Alright, you two, let's get out. Fire in the hole! Ooh! Thank God I'm wearing these sunglasses. Ah, just smell that. Smells like molten plastic and high explosives. The bosses aren't going to be too happy about that.
This place smells like booze and sex.
Kachinko, job is done.
What can I do for you?
Guns are destroyed.
Whoa, you managed to pull that off? Solid work. That ought to gum up the boss's plans.
Alright, next step in breaking up the boss's plans.
Now we cut off the head of the serpent. Big Sol and Nero have to die.
Yeah, why did they need to die?
As long as they're alive, they can start up their plans again. All you've managed to do is stall them. I guarantee you they have contingencies.
All right, how do we take care of them?
They're a little bit upset about what's been done to muck up their plans. They tasked me to find out who's responsible. There isn't going to be another chance to get both of them together in the same room. I'll slip you a gun, and we can take them out.
They're going to expect something from me. You can do it and surprise them.
All right, I'll take care of them. Just give me the word when to start shooting.
All right, what happens when the bosses are gone?
When they're gone, I'm going to run this joint. Don't worry, I'll take care of this place.
All right, you seem like a pretty stand-up guy for someone who doesn't have a lock on his big fat mouth. So let's go take care of these bosses.
Hurry and get ready. I'll be waiting for you there when you're ready.
All right. Well, thanks to our little dip in the armory, we got ourselves a nice trusty assault rifle and also a sniper rifle. I probably should also hotkey that just as a little contingency as well. You know what? We'll use the sawed-off shotgun as well. There we go.
Hey, what can I do for you?
Guess not.
Find yourself a girl or a guy. Have some fun.
Oh, don't worry. I'll be having some fun real soon. Let's just... Yeah, of course, I can't wait here. Can we hear? No. We here? Nope. I wonder if it's because there's that, like, one hostile person that down there is why I can't wait.
I'll take care of them when you're ready. Just say the word. I suggest doing it while they're talking. To
Let's
get the
have
drop
some
on
words.
Them.
Take a seat on the couch so we can get to talk.
Chingu, you're an idiot. Why would you discuss our plans to kill the bosses in front of the bosses? Hello, guys. Can I interest you in some chems?
So I assume you know why we called you here.
Why is Arcade staring longingly into Eddie? Like, he's literally looking at Eddie's ass right now, if Eddie even has an ass. I have no idea what you're talking about.
Well, you've been a real thorn in our side. We've got business plans. You set us back a little bit, I'll admit that. However, we wanted you to know that nothing you did made a shit bit of difference, and you're going to die a failure.
As a last request, would you tell me more about your plan?
Are you shitting me? You didn't even know what the plan was. Yeah, as a last request, I guess we can give you that courtesy.
So, what's the plan?
Caesar asked us to provide a distraction on the Strip. So when he gives the word, we're going to launch an all-out assault on the Strip. First, we're going to blow the embassy. Then we're going to use soldiers to kill every last motherfucker on the Strip. Then we'll run this joint. That'll teach Not at Home what can go on while he sits in his fucking ivory tower lording down from on high.
Well, Nero didn't tell me any of this when he convinced me to take you out.
The fuck? I knew there had to be someone higher up helping you. Nero, you backstabbing, two-timing motherfucker. I knew this day would come.
Time to die, Nero! I shot him in the head and both his arms just came flying off. Man, the momentum from that shot was just amazing. It was literally cartoonish. Well, the job is done. Big Saul, you're an idiot. Nero, you're dead. Take your nice little stuff as a little trophy. Cacino, buddy.
Hey, thanks for all the hard work back there. I'm gonna run a tight ship here. Don't you worry.
Alright, well, I'm planning on playing some games at the casino. Maybe just to pass the time.
Of course. After all you did for me, here are some chips for you. Play. Have some fun.
Alright, take care.
Bye.
Well, that went really easy. You know, to be honest, aside from getting a little hung up from getting Troik out of his contract, but it's not over yet. There's still a chance I might mess this up. I want to make sure. We need to go back to Mick and Ralph's just to check, and if so, then if this went well and I managed to play my cards right, we're going to get a nice little treat. Alright, we've arrived at Mick and Ralph's. Time for the moment of truth, as soon as I kill the radio because I do not want to be hit by a copyright strike.
How's it going, friend?
Or, well, a claim at least.
What I'm referring to.
Alright, let's see. No materials expense, how much? Half. Okay, maybe it was Mick and not Ralph that. Yeah, it was Mick because he's the one who's like the gun runner here. Where did he disappear to? There he is.
That was a real mess the Omertas were looking to create. Glad you could get all that sorted. May have cost me some business, but at least we avoided a shitstorm. Anything I can get you?
Alright, good news. The Omertas say they'll buy arms from you again, even though they technically didn't say it. I managed to convince them off screen.
Outstanding. You have no idea how much this means to me. But I think this little beauty will give you an idea.
Success! Ladies and gentlemen, that funky fresh music just told us that we got ourselves the Pimp Boy 3 Billion. It is basically a diamond-studded golden Pimp Boy that you can unlock. You can actually, if you know, talk to Mick again if you want your original Pimp Boy back. Yeah, switch back to my original Pimp Boy if ever I decide to. But it's actually much bigger than the Pip-Boy originally is, but it's a nice little, like, hidden thing that you can unlock. Plus, the funky fresh tune that it gives out, always a charm to listen to. But that has to do it for this video. Next time on Fallout New Vegas, we're not going to head back to Hoover Dam.
The one who's been going around helping people around here, right? The king says to keep up the good work, instead to give you this.
And I say to the cane, stop interrupting me when I'm doing my outros. Next time on Fallout New... Will you get out of here? Next time on Fallout New Vegas, we're not going back to Hoover Dam. We're going to be heading back to the Strip and doing the job back at Gamora because there's actually one other quest that we can finish, and then we're going to head off to the Ultralux. So until then, I will see you guys next time. Later. What the hell was that? Huh.
Blue moon, you saw me standing alone.